Japan is the land of the rising sun. It has a unique and amazing culture. Unfortunately, Japan does face challenges and is often affected by tsunamis, hurricanes, and earthquakes. But even though Japan faces all these problems, they also come up with millions of innovative solutions. Welcome to TTI. You are watching our Japan series, where we explore the continuous Japanese breakthroughs in the field of science and technology that have a significant impact on today's society.
God bless you, Japan!
Looking at tornadoes on your screen can be cool. However, this rotating, funnel-shaped cloud is extremely dangerous in real life due to the fact that its whirling winds can reach speeds of 300 miles per hour. Tornadoes can appear anywhere and anytime, packing powerful winds and often leaving death and destruction in their path. The worst part is that a tornado is not always visible until it forms a funnel cloud made up of water droplets, dust, and debris. To be well protected against tornadoes, you have to be able to predict how powerful a tornado will be. Fortunately, in 1971, Tetsuya Fujita came up with the Fujita scale, which could predict the future damage done by a tornado.
I could screw up all your plans because I knew your future. That's it. That's how I saved them all.
In 2007, this scale was updated to the Enhanced Fujita scale, which assigns tornadoes a rating based on the estimate wind speed and related damage. The rating goes from EF0 to EF5, where EF0 is considered less severe and EF5 is the most deadly. In the 18th century, the rotating stage was developed for kabuki in Japan by Denshishi Nakamura. Don't know what kabuki is? Well, it's the traditional and historical form of Japanese drama in which you can see people wearing strange makeup, costumes, and performing ancient dances. Most importantly, the revolving stage was created through a fusion of mythological arts and Japanese carpentry tools. Eventually, as Japanese fever, also known as Japonism, reached Europe in 1896, Germany saw its first revolving stage drama at the Residenz Theater in Munich. During this terrible pandemic, it's often necessary for hospitals to know the blood oxygen level of patients, and they do so using an oximeter, which helps to fight against disease with the help of electronics. I want to tell you the story of the oximeter, which undoubtedly has saved countless lives. Many scientists attempted to create blood oximeters before the 1970s. However, they were inaccurate and unreliable due to the noise produced by the continuous pulsing flow of blood in the veins. In 1971, at a Japanese bioelectric company called Nihon Koden, two bioengineers named Takuo Oyagi and Michio Kishi developed a device that successfully measured oxygen saturation in blood by calculating red light versus infrared light absorption, while canceling all other pulsating noises or errors. Oyagi and his colleague Michio Kishi got a patent for it in 1979, and thus the modern oximeter was born.
And modern problems require modern solutions.
If you know someone who has suffered from gastric problems like gastric bleeding, upset stomach, vomiting, a gastric ulcer, or inflammatory bowel disease, then you should probably know who this guy is. His name is Mutsuo Sugimura. He was the Japanese engineer who first developed a gastro camera capable of identifying the root cause of gastric problems in the stomach. Sugimura is the father and mother of the esophago-gastro-duodenoscopy, which is a diagnostic endoscopic procedure that can see the upper part of the gastrointestinal tract down to the duodenum without the need of surgery. This next invention is used in sports, shooting games, and the training of law enforcement agencies and military units. We're talking about the airsoft gun. This device originated in Japan and quickly gained popularity in the Western world too. In the early 1970s, a Japanese photographer named Ishiro Nagata was deeply interested in guns, but didn't like the violence that could be committed using them.
Now be careful. because a 44 Magnum has quite a kick.
Damn, that was fun.
So he came up with a new gun that shot plastic pellets, which could not kill. Those guns gained popularity and were marketed as soft air guns. However, these days the guns are made of high-grade plastics and metals, which make them look very real. Even many police officers cannot easily distinguish them from real guns.
God damn it, stop that!
Oh, no, sir, no, not you.
That's terrific, really.
Darkness is everywhere and can often feel pretty scary, especially at night. Luckily, we have lights. Meet Shuji Nakamura, who won the Nobel Prize in Physics in 2014. Before the 1980s, the world didn't have white-colored LEDs. There were only red and green light-emitting diodes. But during the 1980s and 1990s, Shuji Nakamura, Isamu Akasaki, and Hiroshi Amano created the blue LED by successfully handling the toxic semiconductor gallium nitride. They did so by wearing a homemade spacesuit and breathing through a respirator. In 1995, at Shuji's suggestion, his company developed white LEDs by combining red, green, and blue LEDs. These lights consume less energy, which makes them better for the environment.
The small, energy-efficient, and extremely bright LEDs started a light revolution and are now used in almost every piece of electronics. Without it, much of what we use today wouldn't be possible.
In the 1950s, only 9% of Americans owned TVs. However, that figure exploded to 80% in the 1960s. But Japan was still far ahead of the rest of the world and had created a radically new TV design, which was known as the Seiko TV Watch. The Seiko TV Watch was revealed in Tokyo in 1982 by the Japanese corporation Seiko's Fujimi. At that time, it was the world's smallest TV and became even more popular after being featured in the James Bond movie Octopussy in 1983.
From Seiko comes the world's first ever TV watch. And in the movie Octopussy, James Bond is never without it. A technological breakthrough in the classic 007 tradition. With a clear liquid...
At that time, it was sold for 108,000 yen, or $425 in Japan, and $495 in the US. On a single charge, it could play 5 hours continuously, had a 1.2-inch liquid crystal display screen, and could receive all UHF and VHF channels via a cable to an external TV receiver. If you've seen the X-Men series, you probably thought Magneto had one of the coolest supernatural powers. He can control and levitate any metal around him using magnets. But what if we told you about even more amazing magnets? These are known as neodymium magnets, and they are even more incredible than Magneto's power, because without them, you wouldn't have computers, cell phones, or hard disk drives. They're also used in medical equipment, like MRI scanners, in laser treatments for cancer, and hair removal. Without these magnets, there would be no loudspeakers, headphones, motors, or even wind turbines. The first neodymium magnet was developed by the Japanese giant Sumitomo Special Metals in collaboration with General Motors. Later, the Sumitomo facility became part of the Hitachi Corporation. Today, Hitachi has more than 600 patents just for these MIB neodymium magnets. Next, let's talk about music. In a way, it's everywhere in the universe. The spinning stars, the flow of water, the wind blowing through the leaves of a forest. All of these sounds are actually music from Mother Nature. People love music. Unfortunately, not everyone could be a musician because many people either can't play or can't afford expensive musical instruments. Fortunately, in 1994, a well-known Japanese company called Yamaha introduced the first commercially successful digital instrument, Yamaha VL1, which was a compact musical piano. It worked using physical modeling technology, which could produce algorithmic expressions of music without needing huge and expensive real musical instruments. This algorithmic discovery can simulate many sounds, like the plucked strings, woodwind, brass, and more. It even allows you to play music on your smartphone device with similar software. In the past, audio cassettes were used to record and preserve songs and music. While useful for their time, these devices used analog technologies, which were slow and prone to signal errors and loss of information while transmitting data. This was a big problem, but fortunately it was solved by a Japanese superhero, Hitada Nakajima. In 1971, he resigned from his post at NHK's Acoustics Research and Development Department. He then joined Sony Corporation, where he led Sony's compact disc project and revolutionized commercial digital recordings in the 1970s.
And what you've just been listening to is the ultimate in recorded sound. It will make all conventional disc and cassette systems obsolete. It's dustproof, scratchproof, digitally recorded, read by a laser, and it's called the compact disc.
At Sony, Nakajima pushed for digital audio research, and he was also behind the development of CD technologies. Unlike analog audio, digital audio allows an infinite number of copies to be made without any degradation of signal quality. Because of his work, you don't need to buy a cassette tape or old records to listen to your favorite music. Just browse on the internet and listen to whatever you want.
I'll see you soon.